Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are in Overlook Bay again, as always. I love playing Overlook Bay, as you can tell. Today we're going to be going over the new update that just released this morning. In today's video, we're actually here with our fellow Marshmallow. She is just chilling with us. Here are just a few keynotes of the things that were added into this update. They actually ended up adding light goal rewards, which we are going to go find and check out. They also added new furniture setting to disable the E interaction. So like basically like this little E interaction right here. I'm actually really excited for that feature and I really want to check it out because sometimes whenever I'm recording a video, the UI kind of like gets in the way and stuff, so it'd be pretty nice to check out that feature so that we don't have a bunch of like fingers and E's like telling us to press this and that. The Starlight Dragon is actually going to be leaving the Wishing Well on February 12th. So February 12th is the day of the Valentine's Day Festival, which I'm so excited. As you guys can see, I'm already dressed for the festival with my little wings and my little pink skirt and my hearts going on up here. Anyways, guys, I wanted to tell you that on the day of the update of the Valentine's Day Festival, I am going to be live streaming, so I will make sure to post about that beforehand so that you guys can join my game. But I'm going to be live streaming and we're going to be having so much fun because there are so many things that we can check out. And then lastly, billions of bugs have been crushed within the game. Massive shout out goes to Star Wars for crushing a bunch of bugs and making sure that the Valentine's Day Festival is going to be awesome. I wanted to make sure that I give him a shout out. The whole team's been working so hard. Oh my gosh, guys, I am so excited. Okay, so if we go down here, as you guys can see, I already started my photo wall right here. There's some duplicates. As you can see, like right here with this photo with my boyfriend, I need to change those photos with other photos, but I don't have any currently right now, or I do, I just haven't cropped them and edited. So that disable feature is actually going to be coming in handy with this photo wall, because as you can see, there is so much E interactions. Okay, so if we go into settings right here, we can actually disable furniture interactions. So let's go ahead. Oh my gosh, look at this, guys, the E's are gone. Look at this, and you can still like press it and enter a new image ID and stuff, and you can still use it. Look at this, guys. Okay, so it's not here, but we can still have our pet sit down. We can have Marshmallow sit down over there, and we can still like click it and be able to interact with it and sit down, as you can see. Oh my goodness, where else is another good place to check? Okay, so I do have a lot of UI over here with my pet beds and everything. Let's see, can we still, okay, look at this, guys, we can still add food and water. I think I really do like this feature because we can also put Marshmallow in the little fountain bath right here without any of the UI showing. I really love that. Oh my goodness. Okay, that's gonna be amazing, especially with my little studio up here, because I do have a light fixture underneath like right here, and it usually just shows, but it doesn't show anymore. Guys, look at this. This is going to be amazing. We have a bunch of chairs over here too that used to show a lot of UI as well. So if we sit down, it's not gonna show either. So oh my gosh, I love this. I absolutely love this feature. So this is probably the hard part right here, is being able to do the glitching. So if you do have some glitch builds, you might actually need to turn that back on, the E function, because that is basically how I was able to get into my boyfriend's secret room. So let's go ahead and turn this back on. We have this little seat right here so we can glitch in like this, and then of course glitch back out with that chair. So if you do have a glitch build, this might be an issue, but you can easily just turn it off and on in these settings just like that. Okay, so here is the update board right here if you guys wanted to read it. The Valentine's Day is coming in 6 days, so I'm actually really excited that they added a little countdown right here. Look at, it's in pink and has like a little heart emoji with it. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Okay, oh wow. I thought this was actually going to be located at the park, and I thought I would have to go on like a scavenger hunt on trying to find our little like post right here, like goals post. We're currently at 194,412 likes, and this updates every 10 minutes, so it looks like we are so close to the 2 pet XP weekend. If only I could give this game like 100,000 likes, I would. I've liked this game since the very beginning, so I can't just like give another like. But anyways, guys, look at this. So at 195, we get a 2x pet XP weekend. At 200,000 likes, we get a gold vehicle crate. At 205,000, we get a diamond pet pod. And then at 210,000 likes, we have 10 free wishes, which is perfect for the Valentine's Day update. If you guys didn't know, my friend Cuppy97, her Cupid's teddy pet concept is actually going to be in the Valentine's Day update this game, and it's actually going to be a wishing well pet. So guys, these 10 free wishes are going to be so helpful when we are making wishes at the wishing well, and I do plan on doing a video where I make like probably over 100 wishes to get the Cupid's teddy. My goal is to get 4 so that I can make a rainbow shiny and that I can support my bestie. So yeah, I'm actually really excited for this. I love this. This is actually reminding me and giving me nostalgia from the Halloween update. If you guys remember from the Halloween update, we had the souls goals, I guess you can say, where we had to collect souls and give it to the good witch, and we would get like soul goals too. So like, I don't remember which the prizes were, but we did have some really cool prizes afterwards event, and I think this is a really good way to interact with the game and kind of just have like goals set and stuff. So we looked at the light goals, we also looked at the new furniture disabling feature, we talked about the starlight dragon leaving the game on February 12th. In fact, this is actually the first time I'm logging in today, so let's go ahead and go over to the wishing well and make our wish for the day. And it looks like they have added a sign right here that says starlight dragon leaves in 6 days. I'm really sad that it's leaving because I only currently have 2, which I made into a shiny, and I was really hoping to make a rainbow shiny buttercup. This is Marshmallow's sister, by the way, and then also Cheeto is their brother. So let me find him. Actually, he's not at the top. I'm working on aging him up right now. This is Cheeto right here, and they're all like brothers and sisters. The reason why I say they're brothers and sisters is because they actually came into the New Year's update all together, so that is how they're related. Okay, Marshmallow, let's make a wish of the day. We haven't done one just yet. I have 15 wishes from spinning the pet wheel in the pet shop, and I have one extra wish, free wish for the day, so I'm going to use that. Keep in mind, guys, that wishes do not stack every day, so you only get one wish every day. So make sure that when you log into the game to get your daily rewards, make sure that you come to the wishing well so that you can make a wish as well. So it looks like we have 100 gems, which is going to come in handy because I've also been saving up some gems as well for the update. Everything is confirmed to be gems in the Valentine's Day festival, which I'm so excited. There's not going to be any Robux items, so that means we're all going to be able to get our hands on everything as long as we're grinding for gems and stuff like that. Okay, so Marshmallow needs to go to the park. I don't know if it's too late for this to complete some of these tasks already, but I want to make sure that I get those pet paws, and I'm also trying to max her out as well. It is taking me a lot to max out Marshmallow just because she is a rainbow shiny mythic pet. She is one of the rarest pets. She's actually the second rarest pet in the game. The first rarest pet is the Rainbow Rider, which I don't currently have, which I'm kind of sad, but it's totally fine. I can always trade for it later on. Okay, I'm going to give her a donut because she is deserving of a donut. Look how cute she is when she eats. She's adorable. All right, guys, so that is pretty much it for everything in this update video. There was a lot of bug fixes and a lot of like cool features that were added into the game. Let me know down below in the comments if you guys would like to see a Valentine's Day, like everything we know about the Valentine's Day update type of video. I haven't done a video on everything that is coming for the Valentine's Day festival just because a lot of people have already done a video like that, and I don't want to be repetitive. So let me know if you still would like to see that. I know that some of you guys probably don't have a Discord Discord to follow Overlook Bay on Discord, or have a Twitter to follow, and that which is where like they post all their news and stuff. So I thought it'd be a really great idea to make that video just in case people don't have that type of social media to see the updates. So let me know in the comments if you guys would like to see a video like that. So on the day of the Valentine's Day festival, guys, I am going to be doing a live stream as well as uploading a few videos. I don't know exactly how many videos I'm going to be uploading that day, but I really, really am so excited, and I am just so stoked for this Valentine's Day festival. So expect maybe a triple upload and probably like a lot of videos after that in the next few days after the Valentine's Day update has come. So stay tuned for that. Anyways, guys, make sure to hit that subscribe button so that we can get to 7.5k subscribers. We are so close. I'd love to have you part of our donut squad. So make sure you hit that subscribe button, and also make sure your notifications are enabled so that you guys can get notified whenever I go live or upload a new video, so that you guys can be the first to see those amazing content that is coming to you. I don't know why I'm jumping. Anyways, guys, I will see you guys next time. Bye.